Yes, you guys read that title correctly. Today we are turning a 5 cent investment into $1,000 profit. This is absolutely crazy. I had no plans on making a video tonight. It is currently 12:55. So if I look tired, that's because I am. So like 7 months ago, I was looking at it. I posted a video talking about our biggest percentage profit return ever. And I explained how we bought a huge collection of foreign coins from this like retiring coin dealer. And in that group of foreign coins, there was an itsy bitsy tiny $1 US gold coin from the 1850s. Well, we just beat that. We are nearly at the end of this foreign coin hoard supply. And tonight I just randomly felt like in the mood to sort through thousands of foreign coins and just like finish this stuff off. If you guys remember, we mentioned last video, it was like 1,000 pounds of coins we bought from this retiring coin dealer for just under $5 per pound of foreign coins. There's approximately 100 coins in each pound, so that's 5 cents per coin. But regardless, we buy foreign all the time. Most of it is not full of good stuff. Actually, most foreign, if you buy it online or at coin stores, it just has generic modern stuff in it. It's still really cool, don't get me wrong, but it's not gonna be packed full of old coins like it is in this case. So 7 months later, we were here to finish off the job. And here you can see what we have like left. I guess I have like half of one bucket left, and here's all the stuff I sorted through. This is all just more so generic. I mean, there's still really good stuff in here, but here we go. Here's the little setup, the older, better stuff, pulling out stuff from like Italy from the 1860s, all the old Canadian large cents, all sorts of stuff, Russian coins, German coins, everything you can think of. Cool, funky shaped coins. I mean, squiggly this, square coins. I mean, these I just pull out because they're fun to like give to younger kids because they look so unique and they have like cool little animals on them and stuff. They're not really worth a whole lot. But regardless, this is why foreign coins are so cool. And we retail them all the time, like 15, 20 bucks a pound. People love this stuff. Here are all the exchangeable coins. I mean, literally, we're pulling out Great Britain pounds. These coins are exchangeable for like $1.20 or $1.30 or like euros. The fact that we're pulling out euros out of generic foreign is unheard of. 50 cent euro coins, even Australian coins. This is a $2 Australian coin, exchangeable, I think like 50 something cents per dollar. So this is like $1 US. I mean, just crazy stuff. 50 pence. I mean, tons of exchangeable. And oh my goodness, the silver, not to mention the silver coins. I mean, crowns, Netherlands, French, more Netherlands, Canadian, a silver Australian 50 cent coin. Crazy stuff. German, I mean, this, that, and the other. You guys get the point. Oh, look at this, a Mexican 8 real silver coin. Super duper cool, right? So that's the silver stuff. But let's get to the topic at hand, the title of this video, 5 cents into $1,000. That's unheard of, right? Well, I could not believe my eyes. That's why I whipped out the camera. I was not gonna film this. I was going through my stuff, you know, getting in my zone. I was watching some business documentaries on my laptop here while I was sorting. And all of a sudden, I came across this coin. You guys see that right there? Just looks like a normal copper coin, right? I mean, just chilling there, no big deal. I could not believe my eyes when I picked it up. This is an 1804 draped bust half cent. Obviously, you can see on the back, United States of America. This is not a foreign coin. This is one of the first US coins to ever come off the press in the early 1800s. Very, very rare coin. And it just happens to be in immaculate condition. No, I am not joking. Here come the comments saying, oh, you put this coin in there just to make a video. No, I did not. And one way I can prove that is on the edge of the coin, there are the tiniest little nicks, which indicates that this coin was banging against other coins. So obviously I would not take a perfectly good coin and put those little tiny, tiny, tiny rim nicks. Not enough to really hurt the grading when we send it off to certification, but they are there, and that kind of proves that it's not a coin from my collection or anything like that. What is this coin worth, you wonder? Well, if we take a closer look, there's five different varieties of 1804 half cents. Again, here's the red book. I recommended this in last video. It's a retail price guide, so again, you should be paying way less than the numbers in here. But nonetheless, it's a good idea to get an idea of what coins the US government made, and you know, dating back all the way to the 1700s. This book even has colonial issues. This will come in handy later. Hold on. This 1804, there's five different varieties. All the design of the four, whether there's stems on the reverse, all this is going to sound foreign to you guys if you're not interested in coins, but hey, I hope to teach you guys, you know, continuously through these videos a little bit more about coins. I hope you leave this video knowing more than you started with. So just so happens, this coin is a spiked chin variety, definitely the most iconic variety probably in this entire series of Drake Bus half cents. You can see on Lady Liberty's chin, it literally looks like she has a spike coming out of her chin. Crazy, right? It definitely wasn't like meant to happen. It's just a part of the variety and the dye characteristic. So it's kind of funky looking, but it is very rare and collectible. So this coin in particular, what grade is it? I'm sure you guys are wondering. Like we've said before, condition is everything in the field of numismatics. It's all about what grade the coin is in. Now, grading is on a scale of 1 to 70 in the coin world. 70 being perfect, 1 being absolutely horrible. You find a lot of these in like 1, 2, 3, 4 points out of 70. Rarely do they come this nice. So remember how I said I was going to edutain? Well, let's get into some of that education. So go to this app, download it if you're interested in doing more with coins and grading. It's by PCGS, the leading authentication company and grader for coins. And they built this app to give you, it makes grading a little bit easier. So you come down to the variety of coin. Obviously they have all the varieties, but you come here to half cents and you pick your date or Drake Bust half cent right here. Boom, here you go. They literally show you pictures of all the different grades so you can kind of determine what grade yours is if you're not very skilled with grading. So obviously we're way nicer than this. We're definitely starting to get into this range. Even these, it's nicer than this because XF coins do not have a whole lot of luster. This coin, as you rotate it in the light, you guys can see those lustrous surfaces and the light kind of like rocking over the coin in a pinwheel effect. That is an indication that this coin is very close to uncirculated or could be uncirculated, but in this case, there is a little bit of wear on the high points of the of her hair and of some of the wreath on the back, so it is not uncirculated. Obviously uncirculated, we're talking 60 to 70 points. See how it has a crazy lustrous effect? I mean, these coins are unbelievably rare. One time we had a Drake Bus half cent in MS62 like this. Actually, I think it was a 3. It was very rare. Sold it for like $9,000. Anyway, the 66 is the finest they show. They don't even show any nicer. I mean, to get a 70 out of 70 is impossible on this coin. None exist. But anyway, let's come back down. We're not uncirculated. So now we're looking at the AUs because we're above XF and we're below uncirculated. So now there's 4 grades AU. It could be AU 50, AU 53, 55, and 58. 58 is borderline uncirculated. I don't think we're quite there. If we compare here, I definitely think we could pull off maybe a 53 or a 55. I think when I send in the certification, the graders are really gonna appreciate how original the coin is. They love originality. This coin has not been cleaned. It's not corroded. I am actually shocked at how nice the surface is after all these years. I guess just sitting in the coin dealer's basement mixed in with all these foreign coins maybe helped preserve it. I'm not sure, but it is in remarkable condition. So this coin is worth certifying. What do I mean by certifying? Like I mentioned earlier, the designer of that app, PCGS, they are the leading authenticator and grader for coins. There's NGC as well, Annex, ICG, but PCGS and NGC are the best. So we'll send it off to one of them. It's worth doing on any coins worth, I would say, like $200 to $300 and above. It helps selling the coin. It makes it so easy because when you're selling it to an investor, you can easily say, hey, this is guaranteed authentic by PCGS. They have a buyback guarantee. They are not certifying fake coins. If everything goes as planned, this coin should grade a problem-free, 53-55 range AU. So that's my bet. I can update this video later. Maybe I'll post it on Instagram when it comes back from grading, but my guess, AU53. We'll see. Now what's that worth, you wonder? Well, let me take you to my laptop back here. Let's pull up some auction records, see what these coins actually go for.
So check this out. I think I found a coin that is pretty darn similar looking. Wouldn't you guys say that's pretty accurate? Look, we got the spike chin again, same variety. This coin, I would almost say our coin is nicer. Let's check out the back of this one. See, this one's not bad. So I think we can easily pull off that 55 grade. Here it is, AU55, brown, no problems designated. So what did this coin sell for, you guys are wondering? Well, it sold at Heritage Auctions for 1,000. $57. Are you kidding me? So after a $50 certification fee, we could be looking at $1,000. And given that this coin weighs, let's see here, 5.44 grams, and we paid approximately just under 1 cent per gram, indicates that we're in this coin about 5 cents. So sell for over a thousand, maybe even more if we can get a nice retail figure, or if it grades even higher than we think, that would be a very, very nice profit. And yeah, remember how I was talking about colonials earlier? Oh, let's be very careful with this coin. Always hold a coin by the rim. Do not hold a coin. Let me get a worthless coin. Do not hold a coin like this, or, you know, touch it, smudge it with your fingerprints, or, you know, push it into somewhere. Oh my goodness, you are gonna get all your oils and stuff. Ideally, I should be holding this with like a cotton glove, but you know, I'm very careful to hold it by the rims. That'll protect the coin. That is coin etiquette 101. Do not forget that. Always hold a coin by the rim, and you will preserve it much, much better. Be careful. And just when I thought it couldn't get any better, I came across this coin. I just cannot believe this night. This feels like one big dream. Can you guys read that? Yes. Washington. That is George Washington on the coin. This is called the double-sided, double-headed George Washington colonial copper. It doesn't have a year, but it's actually from the 1780s. Okay, come here to colonials. Man, some of these coins, you guys do not understand what some of these coins are worth. Oh, the bar cent, they call this, made in 1785. Tens of thousands of dollars in nice condition. Whatever the heck this is, I don't even know what some of these coins are. Oh, 50 grand, 110 grand, right here. See, the double-headed cent right there. Lowest grade, they put $100, VF, $250. Online, I've been seeing, check this out. Here it is right here on eBay, available for $200. This one we paid, you know, a whopping 10 cents or whatever after we calculate the weight. Just unbelievable finding colonial coins in what are supposed to be foreign coins. That's really cool. That one, probably won't go off to grading. We'll just list that as is, but the half cent definitely is off to grading. Okay, last bit of edutainment. I want to educate you guys on one other thing. So with these silver coins, sometimes it's hard to tell if a coin is actually silver. A lot of people say, well, how do you know? Like, this 5 pence, how do you know this isn't silver? Or any of these Mexican coins? Or like this big crown, how do you know this isn't silver? It sure looks like it. Or how about these coins that don't even have any English on them, and they surely look silver? So even that kind of sounds a little silver. So sometimes it's all about the color, sometimes it's the way it sounds, sometimes it's the way it's struck. So obviously we have a lot of silver coins over here, but how I want to educate you guys is we're going to walk through this process right here. So if you're not sure, if you don't know off the top of your head, like obviously some of these coins, man, you could just drop them and hear them. You know, that's just classic silver, and it looks like it too. But these two, I am honestly not very sure. This one's some sort of Russian coin from 1888, and this one is a Netherlands 1/4 G 1944. I'm leaning toward not silver, but one way to verify this. So if you're ever not entirely sure, this is what you do. This is a huge life hack. So here we go. We got this coin. We're lucky that it says the country on it, Netherlands, and it says the year and whatever the denomination is, 1/4 G. So what you're gonna do is go to Google. So we'll enter 1944 Netherlands 1-4 G, and then check this out. Add NGC behind it. NGC, one of those companies that authenticates coins, has a huge database of all the foreign coins with their compositions, their values, everything you could want. So on the coin, we can actually see it says Curacao on the back. So I guess they're owned by the Netherlands or something. They must be one of their colonies. Boom, check that out. Top link, Curacao. So this is definitely it. Normally they have the pictures. In this case, they don't. We can easily check out the price here. Okay, $3.50, $7.50. So it's not worth a ton, but we're curious if it's silver, right? So let's go up here to the top right. Boom, composition, silver. And it is 64% silver, and it weighs this much, and its current melt value is $1.70. Isn't that so cool? I was kind of leaning against this being silver. I wasn't sure. It didn't really sound like it, and it just didn't really have the right look. But would you look at that? It is silver, so I can add it to my silver pile, and we just made ourselves a couple bucks. So that's another cool platform. So PhotoGrade, the app for grading US coins, NGC, World Coin Price Guide for looking up compositions, values of coins. I mean, they have everything in here, just every country. It is super valuable. Whatever the heck this coin is, you could have fun with this and you can find some real winners. I've found coins that are worth hundreds of dollars that I had no idea were rare, key dates, stuff like that. So those are two big resources that you guys learned in this video. That's about it for the crazy gem highlights. I mean, there are so many. I still got 30 pounds to go through, so watch me make a part three video because I'm bound to find more stuff. What the heck? What the heck? Literally right here on video. This is a colonial British coin that was used in the early US colonies, dated 1732, I think it says on it. So this was used in the original like 13 colonies before we made our own money. Not worth a ton of money, but still, these are really collectible just because people love early colonial coins. So I'm sure we're bound to find some other cool stuff.
This stuff is awesome. I nerd out about this. I hope you guys learned some things. We talked about grading coins, remember 1 to 70 points. So we determined that half cent using the photo grade app. No, this is not a sponsored video. I wish it was. Please, PCGS, I do a lot of business with you. Hook me up. But we determined it was probably like a 53 out of 70. So we will see if it does indeed grade that in a couple months when it's back. Stay tuned to the Instagram. We learned about the website that I use to look up all these compositions and values of these foreign coins and know what's what. Hope you guys pick some things up. Drop questions down below. I'll be happy to help. And if you guys want to see more coin videos, then let's do it. I know I don't make it to my office too much here. I want to film more videos. It's cool. You guys see all the madness going on behind me, all the coins being sorted. I mean, this is just another day in the life. As I probably said in the intro, I'm going to give somebody a free ounce of silver. And especially now that silver is going nuts the last few days with value, as it should, this is a whole video by itself. Silver is so undervalued in our opinion. I mean, we don't really speculate, but we have a lot of silver. Because gold's approaching its all-time high and silver is still way off its all-time high. It has a ways to go and the ratio value between gold and silver is such a big spread right now when it was normally, you know, a lot closer percentage-wise. So I don't know. This isn't financial advice, but silver is going to do some interesting things. So if you want an ounce of silver, be sure to like this video and drop a comment down below. In the next coin video, we'll randomly pick a winner to win that 1 ounce free silver. So I'm going to go to bed. Or I'm gonna finish sorting these coins and find more winners. We'll see. Thank you guys for watching, and we will see you in the next one.